Well, you know, I fell into football quite unusually, I suppose. You know, a lot of youngsters these days are on the books of professional clubs at the age of 10, 11, 12 even. You know, and they progress through the academy and they get professional training, you know, week in, week out. You know, I was a little bit different. I was a good sportsman. I'm from Harrogate, just north of Leeds in Yorkshire. And, you know, I loved all my sport. I was a great athlete, but it was really football that gave me my opportunity. When I was about 17, I was playing for the county. I got spotted by some scouts from Leeds United, got invited to come down on a trial, and I thought, well, yeah, I've got to give this a go because I love my sport. I got released, funny enough, after 15 months, and I was going to pack in football and pursue something different. But I stuck at it, got an opportunity with Bristol Rovers, and things went on from there. I became a professional footballer, and it gave me a life, and you know, a life that I still enjoy today. That I loved the challenge of it. You know, as anybody can imagine, you know, it's an incredible lifestyle to lead. You get paid handsomely, and you're in a very privileged position. But you know, for me as a sportsman, you know, it's constantly always looking at myself, looking at my performance, always wanting to improve, never resting on my laurels and thinking that I've achieved what I want to achieve. And I think that's, you know, a message for anybody, is to be out there always looking over your shoulder. There'll always be somebody else, you know, to take your place. And I use that to drive me on, to always want to, get better and better. And I enjoyed a great 15-year career in football. I've got a lot to be grateful for. It's incredible when you look back, you know, 1988, Dave Besant, my captain, got the trophy from Princess Diana. Fantastic day. But, you know, it was something I wasn't really aware of until we started this programme, actually, this film. And you look back, and her great-great-uncle, Earl Spencer, wanted to actually enclose the Common. And, you know, to have restricted it to not having common ground here in this area probably wouldn't have enjoyed the sport. You know, right across the board, all sport wouldn't have flourished and enjoyed the success and the fun that it's given to so many people. Because way back in 1864, Earl Spencer wanted to enclose the common land. Parliament stepped in and ensured that that didn't happen. And I think we've got a lot to be grateful for that they did that. Well, yeah, no, I mean, I was very glad to help out TVF way back in 2004 when I first got involved, very limited sort of time, but very happy, loved the ethos and the whole quality and outlook that TVF had. And then, of course, I was contacted about 12 months ago by TVF to do a short film, and I didn't really sort of know too much more about it, and said yes, I would meet and have a chat about it, and of course met the producer, who I don't think had ever written a script or certainly even an essay maybe before. The cameraman chatting to him, and I think was only involved in doing weddings. So I was a sort of a bit miffed, but I said yeah, I'll give some time and be quite happy to contribute my little piece. Thinking it was only a tiny small project, which I think it was at that, you know, that early stages. Suddenly, you know, 12 months later, find out that, you know, so many sports people and celebrities and people have committed their time. The project's grown and grown to a quite phenomenal level, which has surprised me. But it's also pleased me because, you know, these sort of things, the way that they're put together, the time that's been committed, really just shows that people have a lot of time and are quite glad to give their time and effort to a good cause. So I think that's, you know, a tribute to everybody that's been involved in this film. I think there might be some inaccuracies maybe in you know, some of the film. I'm sure there are the consistency with the weather or the locations at times has jumped about a bit, but that's almost, you know, the sort of the nature of the way the project's come together, and also the sort of appeal of the project and the film. And I think people will enjoy it because they'll realise that, you know, everybody's contributed their time free. The film itself has been put together absolutely on a shoestring. And so, you know, sometimes when you see the film at the end, when you go to the cinema, you know, to be seen in the Odeon, this film, you know, that's a great platform for it to be shown at. And sometimes you go there to be entertained with a great, you know, blockbuster from Hollywood. This is going to be very different. I'm really looking forward to seeing the film. I think it's going to entertain people and really show things in a great context, a great light, and really highlight the good work that TVF have done.